ni ufunuo.
Ningependa kusema ya kwamba maisha ambayo tunaishi yanategemea ufunuo ambao tumeweza kuupata. Hauwezi kuishi maisha tofauti na ufunuo ulio nao. Na kwa hivyo, maisha yako yanalingana na ufunuo ambao umeweza kuupata. Na kwa hivyo mtu yote akitaka kuinua ama kubadilisha maisha yake, kile ambacho anahitaji ni revelation, ni ufunuo ambao anauhitaji, ambao uko na uwezo wa kubadilisha maisha yake. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Na kuna ufunuo mara mbili, kuna ufunuo ambao unatokana na Mungu, na pia kuna ufunuo ambao utokana na mapepo na nguvu za giza. Shetani pia ako na maufunuo yake. Na kuna watu wanaishi maisha kulingana na maufunuo ambao wameyapata kutoka kwa ufalme wa giza. Wengine wanajua haya, lakini wengine hawajui kabisa. Wamefungwa macho. The Bible says their mind has been darkened. Mawazo yao yametiwa giza. Na hawajui ya kwamba kile wanachoishi na wanafuata sio ufunuo wa kiungu, ni ufunuo wa kimapepo. Na huu ufunuo wa kimapepo hauko tu nje ya kanisa. Biblia inasema siku hizi za mwisho kuna watu ambao watafundisha hata mambo ambayo wamefunuliwa na mapepo. Kwa hivyo ni vizuri kuwa careful katika maisha yako na kujiuliza, maisha haya ambayo ninayoishi na ufunuo nilio nao, ni Mungu amenisaidia ama umetokana na ufalme wa shetani? Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Revelation empowers our dominion over darkness. You cannot have dominion over the powers of darkness if you don't have any revelation in your life. Hii ndio ilifanya Yesu akamwambia Petero, praise the name of the living God, ya kwamba kama unatembea na huu ufunuo juu yako ama juu ya huu ufunuo, nitalijenga kanisa langu na milango ya kuzimu haitasimama. Kuna watu wengi wameokoka na bado wanaishi na uoga wa mambo mengi katika maisha yao. Lakini ufunuo huondoa hata uoga katika maisha ya mtu. Ukisoma katika kitabu cha John chapter 1 from verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God from the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in darkness, but darkness has not overcome the light. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Neno hili ambalo Biblia inasema ya kwamba in him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light of men is the revelation they have. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. It is the light that they have. The amount of light that you have in your life is determined by the revelation that you have. And the Bible says that darkness has not been able to overcome the light. Giza haijawahi kushinda nuru. Kwa hivyo mtu ambaye ako na ufunuo ako na uwezo wa kushinda nguvu na ufalme wa giza. Ndio Yesu akamwambia Petero, juu yako ama juu ya ufunuo nitajenga kanisa langu na marango ya kuzimu hayatasimama. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. And so the light that is working in your life is determined by the revelation that you have. That is why the Bible says, arise and shine, for your light has come. Immediately revelation comes into your life, you start shining. You are able to arise because of the amount of the revelation that is at work in your life. Praise the name of the living God. And we are not operating at the same level of revelation as much as we are believers. We are not operating at the same level of revelation. There are people who have more light. They are operating at a higher level of revelation. And the more revelation you have, the more dominion you are able to exercise in your life. And once you engage the power of revelation, you walk and move with confidence because you can be able to see clearly and you have dominion over the powers of darkness because of the amount of revelation that is at work in your life. Praise the name of the living God. I activate the power of revelation in your life in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus. I know there are so many people who are serving God, but you can serve God without a revelation. You can serve God because you are following the masses. You can serve God because it is a good thing to do. You can serve God because you just need to identify with God's people. But it is another thing when you do something out of revelation. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. When you give out of revelation, when you pray out of revelation, when you are fasting out of revelation, when you love out of revelation, praise the name of the living God. When you do something out of a revelation, you are unstoppable. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. But there are so many things we can do religiously because it is something good to do. But when you do something out of a revelation, when you worship God out of revelation, people like David, when he was worshiping God, he was worshiping God out of revelation. He did it intentionally. He did it with his whole being. It was not a religious act to him. It was out of a revelation. He could even declare in Psalms 104, I'll enter his gates with praise, with thanksgiving in my heart, and his courts with praise. He knew the power of praising God. He said, three times I'll pray to him, but six times I am going to praise him. He understood the power of worshiping and praising the Lord. Jesus told Peter, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom. The keys of the kingdom is a revelation that you have. A revelation is a key to enter into a door in your life. Praise the name of the living God. Acts chapter 19 from verse 1. When Apollos was at Corinth, Paul took the Lord through to the interior and arrived at Ephesus. There he found some disciples. The Bible says, and asked them, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? They answered, no. We have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit. Huh? So Paul asked, then what baptism did you receive? John's baptism. They replied. Paul told them, Paul said, John's baptism was a baptism of repentance. He told them, he told the people to believe in the one coming after him. That is in Jesus. Mm-hmm. On hearing this, they were baptized into the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul placed his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came on them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. What have I just said? I've said there are so many churches, so many denominations, so many preachers. But even as a preacher, you cannot rise above the revelation that you have. These are two preachers. They are sincere. They are all genuine. Apollos, we know there is, he was somebody who was zealous, who preached with a lot of spiritual fervor. But even as he was preaching and he went to Ephesus, he could only baptize people in John's baptism, and he did not even mention about the Holy Spirit. But when Paul came, he asked them, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you were baptized? He said, the preacher who preached to us did not even mention about the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the living God. And he said, then, which kind of baptism did you receive? Because after baptism, people are supposed to receive the Holy Ghost. They are supposed to receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. They said, we received the baptism of John. And Paul said, this one has expired. For John's baptism was to prepare the way for Jesus. Praise the name of the living God. And now that he has come, we are supposed to baptize people in his name. And when they are baptized in his name, they are born again. And when they are born again, now they are made alive in Christ, and they can receive the Holy Spirit. They can receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. They are connected to the supernatural of God. Praise the name of the living God. And after Paul baptizing them, he laid his hands upon them. And the Bible says they received the Holy Spirit and they prophesied. The measure of God's power in your life is determined by the revelation that you have. That is why I've just said that you can change your life. You can change your situation by engaging the power of revelation. How can I receive revelation in my life? I just wanted to show the simple process and one or two things that you can do to receive revelation in your life. Number one, you must be the redeemed of God. You must accept Christ as Lord to receive divine revelation. The Bible says in the book of Mark, chapter 4, and verse 11, and he said to them, to you it has been given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God. The mystery is the revelation of the kingdom of God. But to those who are outside, all things comes in parables. That means everyone is entitled to read the Bible stories. But it is only the redeemed, the children of God, who are entitled to revelation. So anyone can read the Bible stories. Wanaweza kusoma Biblia kama hadithi. Na wanaweza kusoma kutoka Genesis mpaka Revelation. Hata wasome mara tano. Lakini ni wana wa Mungu waliokombolewa kwa damu. Ambao hao wamepatiwa nafasi ya kupata maufunuo. They have been given to know the mysteries of the kingdom. So the mysteries are not accessible to anyone. Jesus said also in the book of Luke chapter 10 and verse 21. At that time Jesus, full of joy through the Holy Spirit, said, I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to little children. Yes, Father, for this is your good pleasure. These things, they have been hidden to the wise and the learned. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Unaweza kuwa kuna watu ambao wamesoma hata Biblia, lakini mambo haya Mungu ameyapatiana kwa watoto. As many as believed him, they were given the power to become the children of God. A child of God is entitled to revelation. When God spoke to Daniel, Daniel chapter 12 verse 4, but you, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall learn to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. Verse 9. And he said, go your way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed till the time of the end. You can read, but the word is sealed so that not everybody can receive the revelation of the word of God. The only people who are given access to the revelation of the word of God are the children, are the redeemed. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. I declare you are a candidate of revelation because you are the redeemed of God. You are going to walk in the power of revelation. Praise the name of the living God. So number one, revelation begins by accepting Jesus in your life. Number two, you must also receive the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is the master revelator. The Holy Spirit is a master of revelation. Carnal people, people who walk in the flesh, you can be born again, but you become a carnal person. You become a religious person. You'll never receive revelation. Revelation is not for the carnal. Revelation is not for the people who walk in the flesh. Revelation is for the spiritual. Because it is only those who walk in the spirit who can understand spiritual things. Praise the name of the living God. And revelation is spiritual. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So we have been given the Holy Spirit. And we need to engage the Holy Spirit. Even in your prayer. Even when you are leading the word of God. Invite the Holy Spirit and tell Holy Spirit, come and remove the seal. You remember when Saul, who is Paul, was born again. The Bible says scales fell off from his eyes. Magamba. Because when he was persecuting the church, he thought that he was serving God. He was blind spiritually. It is the Holy Spirit who can be able to remove the veil. He removed the seal in the word of God. When you read the word of God, invite him to help you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 10, the Bible says, but God has revealed it to us by his Spirit. And you can see the Spirit is in capital S, the person. And also, the Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. The Holy Spirit searches all things, even the deep things. If you want to understand the mysteries of the kingdom, if you want to understand the deep things of God, it is the Holy Spirit who can be able to reveal. But God has revealed it to us by his Holy Spirit. So after giving your life to Jesus, the next step that you need is a step of the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Ndipo wakati Paul alienda Ephesus na akakuta kuna watu wameamini. Alijua the next step, they need to receive the Holy Spirit. So alienda mara moja, akawauliza, na wakati mliamini, mlipokea Roho Mtakatifu. Wakasema hapana. Sisi hata kusikia kama kuna Roho Takatifu hatujasikia. Akajua hawa watu hawataweza kusonga mbele, hawataweza kuwa na dominion. So mara moja akaenda akawabatiza, akawawekelea mikono, wakajazwa na Roho Mtakatifu. Akajua kama wamejazwa na Roho Mtakatifu, they are going to understand the deep things of God. Praise the name of the living God. Unajua kuna watu naweza argue na wao mambo ya Biblia, lakini wako katika mwili. Kwa sababu kuna mambo ambayo they are deep things of God. They are not in the shallow waters. Na hayawezi kupatikana na kila mtu. Diposa hata Biblia imesema usimwage ruru mahali kuna gurue. Kuna mambo Mungu anaweza kukuaminia. And you cannot even share with everybody. Because some people are very far. Ukishiriki na wao, watakanyanga huo ufunuo na wakukanyange wewe, wakurarue. Waseme wewe ni mjinga. Praise the name of the living God. Kwa sababu ni mambo ya ndani ya Mungu. Na yanajulikana kupitia Roho Mtakatifu. Praise the name of the living God. So number one, step number one, receiving Christ. Step number two, receiving the Holy Spirit. Step number three, spending time in the presence of God. Spending time in the presence of God. When you spend time in his presence, you receive divine knowledge. You know, there are some people who don't understand why we have to spend time in the presence of God. Hawajui hii maombi huwa tunaomba kila wakati. Hizi kesha tunafanya kila wakati. Ni za nini? Nini hii unaomba kila wakati? There is a difference in prayer. When people spend time in the presence of God. Mimi kuna solutions nyingi ambazo huwa napata katika maisha yangu. Mimi kuna majibu mengi huwa ninapata katika huduma. Ninapata njia ya kutatua shida. When I spend time in the presence of God. Mimi hata wakati naona giza giza. Naona kuna mambo yananilemea. Ninajua there is one key I need. I just need to spend time in the presence of God. And when I spend time in the presence of God, I receive divine knowledge concerning that situation. And I'll be able to receive a breakthrough. Praise the name of the living God. So spending time in the presence of God is a key to divine knowledge. Praise the name of the living God. And that is why people are too busy. They don't have answers for their problems. But they don't also have time to spend in the presence of God so that they can receive divine knowledge or they can receive a revelation concerning their situation. Bwana apewe sifa. Kuna wakati unafaa kuchukua muda and you engage in an area of concern. Yani tuseme, you want divine prosperity. You can take time in the presence of God. You engage in that area of concern and tell God, I desire to receive revelation concerning divine prosperity. Because when you want to do an exam of chemistry, you don't read geography. So sometimes you engage in an area of concern, engaging in the scripture, engaging in the presence of God, and just asking God, give me a revelation concerning this area. Pengine it is an area the enemy is trying to hit you hard. Maybe it is the area of marriage. Na umejaribu kufunga mapepo yote, na bado doa haitulii. Need to spend time. Ukiona the devil is hitting you hard in an area, you spend time searching and researching in an area of concern. You desire to walk in the power of God. Spend time. Search in the scriptures. Read some books. Spend time in the presence of God. Na umwambie Bwana, nataka nipate ufunuo juu ya nguvu zako. Juu ya utukufu wako. Praise the name of the living God. Kuna mambo tunasoma tu katika Biblia, lakini tunaweza pata ufunuo na ufunuo ndio utusaidia kuweza kumiliki. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Because tunaishi nyakati mbaya. Mafundisho ya uongo ni mengi. Watu wengine wameanza kusema ni wakati wa neema, umesamehewa dhambi zile ulitenda, zile unatenda. Na zile utakazotenda ulisamehewa in advance. So wewe endelea kutenda, zote zimesamehewa. Na wengine wanafurahia hiyo injili. Praise the name of the living God. But I know the power of repentance. Kuna mambo unafaa kujua na unajua na unajua ya kwamba unajua. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So you can be able to engage in searching knowledge in an area of concern. Isaiah 5:13. Therefore my people will go into exile for lack of understanding. Their men of rank will die of hunger and their masses will be parched with thirst. Praise the name of the living God. Mungu anasema, my people will go into exile for lack of understanding. Even their men of rank, watu wake walio na cheo, waitwe archbishop, waitwe bishop, hata wale walio na cheo, hata wao watakufa kwa njaa. Na makutano pia ya watu, na wao watakuwa na kiu. Kwa sababu gani? They lack understanding. Hawana ufunuo wowote. Kuna watu, they are in captivity. They are in exile. Wako katika kifungo fulani katika maisha yao. Na one revelation inaweza kuwatoa katika hicho kifungo. Lakini wakikosa ufunuo, wanaweza ishi katika kile kifungo maisha yao yote. I pray for you today as we finish this service. May you receive the revelation you need to come out of your captivity. I declare before the end of this year, you are coming out of your captivity. I am coming out of every captivity in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive the revelation you need. Whichever area you have been into captivity, I declare your freedom. In the mighty name of Jesus, before the end of the year, your freedom is coming. In the mighty name of Jesus, none of us is going to be into captivity of the enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release the revelation you need.
Kilabaganda rababosh, rekabaganda ribaboshata rabaganda rimamozaya.
What else can help you to walk in liberation is becoming a friend of God. Becoming a friend of God. Jesus said in the book of John, chapter 15 and verse 15, the Bible says, "No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all things that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you." You are not servants. You are in another level. You are friends. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. When you become a true lover of God, you have access without struggle to divine liberation. When you become a true lover, yani wewe ni mtu ambaye hauna unafiki, yani unampenda tu Mungu katika maisha yako. Wewe sio mambo na dini. You love God. Na Mungu anasema, wale wanaonipenda, ninawapenda. Praise the name of the living God. Na kuna mambo katika maisha yangu. Sio kila mtu anaweza kuyajua. Ni rafiki tu. Na hata wewe kuna mambo katika maisha yako. Ambayo haujawahi kuambia mtu. Kuna watu tu wa kawaida katika maisha yako. Wanajua maisha yako mambo ya kawaida. Lakini marafiki. Na wakiwa marafiki wa dhati, wanajua mambo ya siri katika maisha yako kwa sababu marafiki hufunguliwa moyo. Ukiwa rafiki wa kweli wa Mungu, Mungu anakufungulia moyo wake. Unajua siri za ufalme. Inasema ya kwamba siri za Bwana ziko pamoja na wale wa mchao. Praise the name of the living God. Hey, when you are a true lover of God, you walk in divine liberation. Wakati Mungu alikuwa anaenda kuharibu Sodoma, alisema, "Je, nitafanya hili jambo bila kumwambia Abraham?" Abraham was a friend of God. Na Mungu akasema, "Hii siwezi kumficha." Kuna wakati unaonekana mjinga. Ni kama umepoteza maisha yako. Ni kama haujui kile ambacho unafanya. Kumbe wakati umeshika hiyo njia. Ninasema kwamba kuna njia ambayo hata ule tai yako na macho anaonaga kutoka mbali. Hiyo njia hajaitembelea. Hata ule simba anayewika jangwani, hiyo njia bado hajaijua. Kunako kanjia ambako Mungu anaweza kukufunulia. Ukitembelea hiyo njia, hata mapepo hayakuoni. I release a revelation that is going to take you to the next level. I release a revelation in the mighty name of Jesus that is going to change your situation in the mighty name of Jesus. I release an activation by the Holy Spirit. Yes, he who searches the deep things of God, may he help you in the mighty name of Jesus to get into a place of divine revelation in the name of Jesus.